Hi everyone, my name is Augwind, founder and CEO of Augwind. Here at Augwind, we develop an energy storage solution that fills a crucial gap in energy transition. By blending principles from compressed air energy storage and pumped hydro energy storage, we offer a cost-efficient and clean energy storage solution. Here in Yahel, which is located in southern Israel, we have our upgraded demonstration site for this technology, which we name AirBattery. The AirBattery is tailored for multi-day grid-scale applications, playing a vital role in ensuring grid reliability for systems relying on intermittent renewables. While this demonstration site currently consists of a single small module, commercial installations will comprise multiple, much larger modules. The module includes pumps, underground compression chambers, underground air reservoir, and turbines positioned right over there. Now, let's go to the control room to see exactly how it works. This is Ilan, one of our engineers from the R&D team, who continuously helping us improving our technology. This is the system. As you can see, the reservoir pressure is currently set to 8 bar. In order to increase it, we'll send a new bubble of compressed air from the compression chamber. Ilan is using electricity from the grid in order to activate an array of pumps. The pump pushes water from compression chamber number 1 into compression chamber number 2. The air in compression chamber number 2 is isothermally compressed by water. Once the pressure exceeds 8 bar, a valve opens and delivers the compressed air into the reservoir. As we can see, the pump efficiency currently set at 78%. You can hear the pump drinking water through this pipe, compress the air in the chambers below, thanks to three things: the large surface area of the water, the constant underground temperature, and the state-of-the-art control architecture. We managed to compress the air in a fully isothermal process. At this site, we are able to do so in a pressure of up to 40 bar. In commercial grid-scale facility, the storage element will be comprised of geological salt caverns, reaching much higher pressure at a very low cost, providing hundreds of hours of electricity. Now we'll demonstrate how we discharge the system, providing electricity to the grid. Ilan, please prepare the discharge process. We have two turbine machines for discharging. One is a highly efficient Pelton turbine designed for high pressure. The other one is a Francis turbine designed for low pressure. In order to convert compressed air into electricity, a bubble of air is delivered from the reservoir to the water fill tanks and pushes water toward the turbine as it expands. By doing so, the water turbine spins and generates electricity. This is the high pressure Pelton turbine. It runs on water. It actually runs on water in a closed loop, meaning water is being delivered from the compression chamber through this pipe into the Pelton turbine, which spins. After the water leaves the turbine, it goes back into the compression chamber, back and forth in a closed loop. Now let's see how it actually looks in the control room. Here we can see that the turbine discharge efficiency is 90%. Currently, the average discharge efficiency is 70%, while the average charge efficiency is 64%. At this early commissioning phase, we've reached an AC to AC round trip efficiency of 45%. We expect to gain higher efficiency in the upcoming weeks. At the commercial scale, we target efficiency of above 60%. If it sounds interesting to you and you want to learn more details about it, please contact us to learn more about the AirBattery technology.